Hi folks, and welcome back to Bullet Points. Today we're talking about the Savage Model 1899. I know this is a big jump from our last Winchester 92, and there was a lot of different models that did get left out. However, we're pretty young in the game here, and we can't exactly get a hold of every rifle we want to play with. So I do have the 99. I do want to go through that with you guys, and it is, you'll appreciate the engineering advances in just a few years between the 92 and the 99. The Savage was new to the game. Winchester had obviously been doing it for, about 30 years, almost 40 years at this point, selling hundreds of thousands of rifles. And Arthur Savage was this young guy, a British citizen, who was actually born in Jamaica. His dad worked for their State Department. Loved adventure. In his 20s, he wanted to go check out Australia. While there, he was captured by Aborigines and held prisoner or lived with them. I'm not sure exactly how that story goes. Savage then ends up in the U.S. working as a superintendent for a railroad company. Does that for a bit, and in his spare time, starts designing rifles. His first attempt was the 1895, which was the direct predecessor to the 1899. He had a lot of really neat ideas that he integrated into it, just didn't have a lot of capital to really put it into full production. So he got it on his business hat, went out and found some other investors, and worked with the Marlin Company to actually help him produce the early 99s. And if you look on an early 99, there is a barrel stamp that's JM. And that JM means that it was actually manufactured by Marlin Company using Arthur Savage's design. So Arthur Savage, with his young company, wanted to go ahead and get in on these government contracts that had really been dominated by Winchester and some of the bigger names for Winchester and Springfield and those other bigger companies. So what the government started looking for was they wanted a rifle that could shoot a higher power round, particularly one that was a Spitzer point. So instead of our flat round or round nosed ammunition that we've been firing out of our other lever actions, they wanted to move up to a pointed bullet that was going to increase accuracy and increase the amount of power behind it. So more range, more accurate, more devastation on the battlefield. Prior to our Spitzer points, we've only been firing flat or round nose bullets out of our lever actions. I'll step up here and show you. The reason for that is in all of our other featured rifles that we've talked about so far, they all have a tubular magazine that goes underneath the barrel. And in there, the rounds have to nest, one stacking on top of the other. And by having a flat or a rounded tip, you're not going to detonate the primer of the preceding round. So you can't do that with Spitzer points because the Spitzer point itself will act as the firing pin to all the other rounds in the magazine. Winchester went ahead in their 1895 model and created a box style magazine that allowed you to put all the rounds stacked on top of each other vertically as opposed to horizontally. Savage looked at that and said, hey, that's cool and it's functional, but we can do something better. In the 95, he created a rotary magazine. He didn't get the contract, the initial contract that he bid for, so he decided to go ahead and scrap that one, take care of the issues that it had. The few issues that it did have was there were some open ports throughout the receiver that allowed you to look into it to make sure that it was loaded or unloaded, cocked or not cocked. Those areas that were open tended to grab dirt and debris, causing the rifle to fail to function. It was just too close to firing pins, so once you got dirt in there, it could bind up in the spring of the firing pin or into the trigger mechanism, and it just wouldn't fire. So the 99, what he did was he went and closed up a ton on the receiver and still maintained his rotary magazine. He also designed this lever which actually works from the back end. All of the, if you can see that, that bar there attaches to the back side of the bolt, where almost every other one that we looked at with Winchester or Henry, it was directly from underneath this portion of the lever that functioned the bolt and the bolt carrier. By putting this on the back end, when it all locks up, it locks up very tight and it can handle a whole lot more pressure than anything that was being or anything that was being fulcrum from right underneath it. So the rotary magazine sits right in there. It is a brass magazine, and there is a spring, which I cannot show you, but it's right here. It's twisted around, and then it sits in there. It looks like a D, a big letter D. As you twist around, there's one flat side that you'll slide into the receiver once you have the tension on it, and it stays put. Taking that apart to clean it is about the most nerve-wracking thing on earth. I highly suggest that if you're going to do it, do your studies first, know exactly what you're doing before you get into it, and also have a large clean area that you can make sure you can find any springs that jump out on you, or small pins, screws, that kind of stuff. The rotary magazine works very simply. You place your round and push it in, and the next one will feed directly on top of it. I'm going to close the bolt without feeding that round in and show you on this side. Savage has this neat little window here. And if you can see there, that is the number one, telling you that there is one round loaded in this magazine. So we'll cycle it. Does not like to cycle when it's directly vertical. Now that there's a round loaded in the magazine, it's showing us that there's, or loaded in the breech, showing us that there's zero left in the magazine. And as you heard, I just ejected that round. We're safe, we're clear again. This is where he decided to put his safety at. Once the safety's up, you cannot cock. Safety's out of battery, then you can close that up, depress the trigger, and you're completely unloaded. Another neat feature that he did that I can show you right now while we're up here, if you notice right along the top of the receiver here, you can't see anything except for some holes. Those holes are for scope mounting. Now you see that pin up. When that pin is sticking up out of the receiver, it's telling you that your gun is cocked. So he added a lot of neat little safety mechanisms into this firearm that we hadn't seen before in any of the Winchesters or Henrys that were out there. When it comes to the functionality of this rifle, this particular one was my grandfather's, and it's chambered in .308. So I know that this gun was produced somewhere in the early 60s. Anything after that had a different four stock, but it was right after the .308 came out. Savage did a great job with this rifle of putting it into so many different chamberings that it didn't matter if you were an Eastern hunter or a Western hunter, you were going to get the caliber that you were looking for. And it was put into a lightweight package that you can carry this thing anywhere. They even in the 70s made a takedown version of this for bush pilots that were out in Alaska, to where the barrel and everything twisted off with a half turn, and you had your receiver and stock on one piece and your barrel on another piece, and came in a little tin can carrying case. Very neat deal. This rifle has been around my family for, good grief, almost 80 years now. Not 80 years, 60 years. 60 years of use. I still carry this rifle out elk hunting. It is an outstanding rifle. It shoots accurately up to 500 yards without a scope. You put a scope on it, and I give it good accuracy out to about 600 yards. Anything more than that, it does start to spread out a little bit, but it was never designed to be a precision rifle. It was designed to be a hunting rifle. And most hunters would say that an ethical shot on an animal is usually you know, 300 to 400 yards is a pretty long poke. So even by today's standards of rifle manufacturer and what you expect to get out of a off-the-shelf rifle, this will hold up to it. Savage actually continued to make these until 1998. They never went out of production. They were always very popular. As they ran into some, you know, manufacturing issues and buying and selling of the company, they decided to phase out the 99. So it did not quite make it to its centennial mark. But doggone it, it sure should have. But the 1899 manufactured for 99 years. That's pretty cool. If you have one of these, please tell me what you think about yours. I know there's a ton of them out there. They're not highly unique, but they are highly sought after. It seems like either this or the Winchester 94 and 30-30 were the deer guns to have from the time of inception all the way, you know, through the 70s until, you know, bolt action really caught on. But this is a hell of a gun. I love it. I hope you love yours. Please drop it in the comments. Let me know. Remember, like, and share. Thanks a lot for visiting us with Bullet Points. Till next time, guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your time. And enjoy shooting. Welcome to Central Iowa Impact. This is my happy place. With being out at the house and shooting, it's not always safe for us to shoot our larger guns out there. So we come in here. We have a nice climate-controlled range, motorized targets. I don't have to get muddy. I don't have to get wet. I don't have to get covered in grass clippings. I come in here, I shoot, I put my stuff away, I go home. Can't beat an indoor range, and really encourage anybody that needs anything firearm related, whether it's maintenance or purchasing new, come over to Central Iowa Impact and see what they can do for you guys. Colby, what's new in here?
Oh, well, not much. Right now, we do have quite a bit on hand. However, with the current market, things are getting a little bit tight, but that's not a big deal. We can still get things, it just takes a little longer. However, we are in our service area, so this is what we do have for firearms. These are our handgun cases. We do have both. I have AR-15 parts and pieces. Got a rack full of long guns right now. Feel free to stop in.